Hello and welcome you all. Dear students, this is the last topic of unit number 5 of the subject digital communication. So today's topic is information capacity theorem, which is also called Shannon-Hartley theorem. From the exam point of view, we may expect the question like this: state channel coding theorem or state information capacity theorem, that is Shannon-Hartley theorem. First, we will discuss the channel coding theorem, which is also called Shannon's second theorem. In the earlier video, we have discussed Shannon's first theorem. Now, statement of channel coding theorem: given source of m equally likely messages, मतलब एक source है जो generate करता है m messages which are equally likely and number of messages are very very greater than 1, generating an information at a rate r, मतलब information rate is r, also given a channel capacity c, the messages which we want to transmit through the channel is having channel capacity c, then if r is less than or equals to c, मतलब जो information rate है that should be less than or equals to the channel capacity, then there exists a coding technique such that the source output can be transmitted over the channel having arbitrarily small probability of error in the received signal. In short, एक source है अपने पास जो m message generate कर रहा है, अगर channel capacity c है और rate of transmission r is less than or equals to c, then you can faithfully transmit the messages with very very small probability of error. Such messages can be transmitted over a channel. This is the statement of channel coding theorem. Next, Shannon-Hartley theorem, which is also called information capacity theorem. So the statement is a channel capacity. Basically, channel capacity का मतलब क्या है कि इतने amount तक, ये particular amount तक channel can faithfully transmit the messages, which is called channel capacity. So the channel capacity of continuous channel of bandwidth, BW means bandwidth, continuous channel of bandwidth B hertz having an additive white Gaussian noise of PSD, PSD means power spectral density, N0/2, ये N0/2 जो है, that is value of PSD, power spectral density, over a bandwidth of B hertz is given by, means in short, एक channel है, जिसका capacity का formula हमें लिखना है, bandwidth is B hertz, and PSD upon white Gaussian noise, additive white Gaussian noise, is N0/2, then in such case, channel capacity is given by B means bandwidth log to the base 2 1 plus s by n0b. S means signal power, so s by n0 into b, bits per second. That is the statement of Shannon-Hartley theorem. Now let us solve few numericals. First problem: an ideal communication system with average power limitation and white Gaussian noise has a BW, that means bandwidth, of 1 megahertz. We know 1 megahertz is 10 raised to 6 hertz, and S by N, that is signal to noise ratio, of 10. First part, determine the channel capacity. Second part, if S by N ratio drops to 5, pehle 10 diya hai ratio, if it drops to 5, what bandwidth is required for the same channel capacity? Third part, if bandwidth is decreased to 0.5 megahertz, pehle bandwidth 1 megahertz hai, if it is decreased to 0.5 megahertz, what S by N ratio is required to maintain the same channel capacity. Ab dekho, as far as numericals are concerned, you might need this equation in most of the numericals. So C is the channel capacity, which is equals to B log to the base 2 1 plus S by N. Abhi jo isse pehle jo humne formula discuss kiya, that was S by N0 into B. Don't get confused, S by N0 is signal to noise spectral density. S by N is only signal to noise ratio. In the question, S by N ratio is mentioned, so we are going to make use of this formula. So let us start the calculation. So first part, we'll have to obtain the channel capacity. We have this formula B, that is bandwidth log to the base 2 1 plus S by N. The original given values are, bandwidth is 1 megahertz, so let us put the values. 1 megahertz means 1 into 10 raised to 6 hertz. This is value of B. Log to the base 2, 1 plus s by n. Initially, given ratio of s by n is 10. So it is 1 plus 10, which is same as 10 raised to 6 log to the base 11. You will have to solve this. You know the procedure. Agar calculator pe directly ye nahi aata hai, log to the base 2 of 11. You will have to do it like this. Log 11 to the base 10 divided by log 2 to the base 10. So if you solve this on the calculator, this answer of channel capacity will be 3.4594 into 10 raised to 6 aata hai. Matlab, I am writing it like this, megabytes per second. जैसे मैंने बताया ये आंसर आता है 3.4594 इनटू 10 रेस्ट टू 6 इनटू 10 रेस्ट टू 6 मींस मेगाबाइट्स पर सेकंड. सो दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्ट, दैट इज आंसर ऑफ चैनल कैपेसिटी. सेकंड पार्ट, अब देखो व्हाट इज मेंशन, एस बाय एन रेशियो ड्रॉप्स टू 5, व्हाट बैंडविड्थ इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द सेम चैनल कैपेसिटी. चैनल कैपेसिटी रिमेन सेम, ये फॉर्मूला है चैनल कैपेसिटी का. सो सेम चैनल कैपेसिटी मींस आई विल राइट इट लाइक दिस, 3.4594 mega hai, so it is into 10 raised to 6 equals to, I am making use of this same formula. So isme bandwidth calculate karna hai, what bandwidth is required for the same channel capacity if now s by n ratio drops to 5. So this is equals to b calculate karna hai, I will keep it as it is, log to the base 2 1 plus. अब जो s by n का वैल्यू है ये क्लियरली मेंशन किया है, इट ड्रॉप्स टू 5, सो इट इज 1 प्लस 5. सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज b log टू द बेस 2 ऑफ 6. सो दिस कैलकुलेशन कैन बी रिटन एज b, दैट इज बैंडविड्थ इज इक्वल्स टू 3.4594 इनटू 10 रेस्ट टू 6 अपॉन log टू द बेस log 6 एंड बेस ऑफ log इज 2. सो इफ यू सॉल्व दिस then answer will be 1.33 megahertz, that is 1.33 into 10 raised to 6 hertz. So this is the answer of second part. Third part, if bandwidth is decreased to 0.5 megahertz, original bandwidth they have 1 megahertz, if it is decreased to 0.5 megahertz, what s by n ratio is required to maintain the same channel capacity. Again I am going to make use of same formula. Same channel capacity means 3.4594 into 10 raised to 6 is equals to. अब B का जो value इस formula में, B का जो value है, ये question में दिया है, that is decreased to 0.5 megahertz. तो I will write it like this, 0.5 into 10 raised to 6, mega means 10 raised to 6. ये B का value put किया, log to the base 2, 1 plus S by N. अब ये simplify करना है, so I will write it like this, log to the base 2 1 plus s by n is equals to 3.4594 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 0.5 into 10 raised to 6. So if you solve this on the calculator, you will get the answer of RHS part. So it is 6.9188. ye answer aaya hai is term ka. Log to the base 2 1 plus s by n is 6.9188. Up, we need to calculate s by n, so take anti log on both sides, make the thing simple. Ye log ka base 2 hai, matlab anti log lena hai, matlab LHS mein anti log lenge to log sign cancel ho jayega. So at the LHS I will be getting 1 plus s by n is equals to anti log. Matlab kya karna, ye jo division ka answer aaya hai, ye wala answer, this I will be writing it as 2 raised to 6.9188. So simple, s by n is 2 raised to 6.9188 minus 1. ये calculator पे solve करना है, so value of s by n will be 119.99. This is the value of signal to noise ratio. But always remember, s by n ratio must be expressed in decibels. So in terms of decibels, I will write it like this, s by n in dB is equals to 10 log 119.99. Don't get confused. यहाँ पे dB में जब हम लोग convert करते हैं, तो log का base 10 होना चाहिए. This base should not be 2. So this answer will be 20.79 dB. This is the answer of last part of this numerical. Next problem, a voice grade telephone channel has bandwidth of 3400 hertz. So this is the given value of B, that is bandwidth. If S by N ratio, which is given in terms of dB, which is 30 dB, determine capacity of a channel. If this channel is used to transmit 48 kbps of data, determine the minimum SNR, that is signal to noise ratio, required for the same channel. So first part, let us calculate the channel capacity. See, the given value of S by N is 30 dB. Ye dB mein value hai. Don't directly take this value and start doing calculations. We need to convert this value into normal unit. Ye kaise convert karna hai? देखो S by N is given as 30 dB. हम लोग dB में ये value कैसे calculate करते हैं? S by N ratio in dB is equals to 10 log of S by N. This is the way how to calculate S by N ratio in dB. तो dB का जो value दिया है, that is 30. So I will write it like this. 30 is equals to 10 log of S by N. Therefore, log of S by N and this log is to the base 10. हमेशा याद रखना है, dB में calculate करते वक्त log का base 10 होता है. So if I will transfer this 10 at the LHS, so it is 30 upon 10, that is 3. Take anti-log. Anti-log मतलब ये log cancel हो जाएगा, सिर्फ S by N आ जाएगा. और anti-log मतलब यहाँ base 10 है, so it is 10 raised to 3, that is 1000. So 30 dB corresponds to S by N ratio of 1000. Now we have the formula of channel capacity. C is equals to B log to the base 2 1 plus S by N. So put the values. Bandwidth is 3400 hertz. 3400 log to the base 2 1 plus S by N. जैसे मैंने बताया, common mistake students करते हैं, S by N का direct value dB का यहाँ पे नहीं put करना है, जो हमने अभी simplify करके obtain किया है, मतलब this normal value, that is 1000. So you need to put this value 1000. So simply solve this. It is log to the base 2 of 1001 into 3400. So this answer will be 33.89 into 10 raised to 3 आ रहा है. So I will write it like this, kbps, that is kilobytes per second. जैसे मैंने बताया, answer आ रहा है 33.89 into 10 raised to 3 means kilobytes per second. ये हो गया first part का answer. Second part, if this channel is used to transmit 48 kbps of data, मतलब अभी जो डेटा दिया है, that is 48 kbps, determine the minimum SNR required for the channel. So this data is 48 kbps, so I will write this first part. For second part, I will write it like this, 48 kbps, मतलब 48 into 10 raised to 3 is equals to, again I am making use of same formula, C, that is the channel capacity, which is same as 48 kbps, which is equals to B, that is bandwidth 3400 log to the base 2 1 plus S by N. अब सिंपल है, S by N का वैल्यू हमें कैलकुलेट करना है. So rewrite the equation like this, log to the base 2 1 plus S by N is equals to 48 into 10 raised to 3 upon 3400. Then like the previous sum, you'll have to take anti-log. So if you take anti-log on both sides, you will get 1 plus S by N is equals to 2 raised to this entire value. So 2 raised to 48,000 upon 3400. So S by N will be this value minus 1. So if you solve this, S by N will be whatever value you'll be getting, minus 1. So value of S by N will be 17775. Now since this is S by N ratio, what I said in earlier numerical, hamesha S by N ratio dB mein express karna hai. So for dB, I will write it like this, S by N in dB is equals to 10 log, dB mein karte waqt log ka base 10 hona chahiye, 17775. So this answer will be 42.5 decibels. This is the new value of signal to noise ratio. So this is the way how to solve the numericals as far as this information capacity theorem is concerned. So I have covered, these are the only possible variations, because these numericals are direct formula based and we need to make use of this formula, same formula of channel capacity. Suppose agar S by N ratio ke badle mein, suppose given ratio is S by N0 in some numerical, then only modification is, jo humne theorem discuss karte vakt formula discuss kiya, only modification will be, this will be S by N0B, that's it. Remaining all the things will be as it is. So that's it for this session. So thank you. Thanks a lot for watching this video.